muscles to have to blow them big. How's everybody? Let's give yourself a hand for being here. That's one thing. Good afternoon. It's so good to see all of you all out for this very festive and special occasion. Today we're here, as you all know, to unveil a marker, a historical marker, on an apple. I see so many of you all that I know that still live in apple. Some of you all probably trying to forget this. So we're going to go in and begin. First of all, I want to thank the good Lord for all the sunshine he's given us all week long. Secondly, I want to thank him for letting the clouds come over right now for a little while. Thirdly, we're going to ask the good Lord that you hold your rain until we finish. And with that being said, I want to thank all of you all again. I want to thank the Lord for my help. I want to thank the mayor, Honorable Jim Byard, for being here with us. All that he's done to help with this process. I want to thank Melvin Kane, especially for spearheading. He spearheaded this process. I did a magnificent job. Along with everyone that works in the mayor's office, the historical commission, some of you all who interviewed during the process, everybody that was involved in making this a reality. So thank you all. Thank you so much for coming. Finally, before I leave, thank you for supporting me as the councilman for this district. Thank you very much. With that, let Mayor Byard come, and then Ms. Kane will come and have a few words, and then we'll have an unveil. Thank you so much.
I think since it hadn't been this cloudy in several weeks, we might ought to gather every Monday at 4:30 right here. We can place the rain on us. That'd be good. Willie said that Miss Kane spearheaded this. Let me tell you how this went. Miss Kane was my high school teacher all the way through. And Mr. Kane taught me how to drive. So Miss Kane came down and said she had an idea. And y'all all had high school teachers. You can't say no to them. So I said, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. And that's the way this got here. All I did was say, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. And so she's got some other things up her sleeve. She said she's coming. I want to tell you something. You know, I've lived in California since I was 4, so I remember having my whole life. And I'm 44, and people my age who grew up will know this is Happy Holidays. And people who are younger than us, than my age, they don't rightly remember Happy Holidays. My memory of Happy Holidays is Carl Stoudemire right down there singing. And my only regret today is that he's not down there on that corner. Oh, that's Happy Hollow to me, is Carl Stoudemire down there singing. So I asked one time, y'all remember Mr. Charles Rice? Y'all remember Mr. Rice? He lived up on Goldfield. And one time he said, he was talking about Happy Hollow, and he was talking about Happy because he was the 30s. Some of y'all, I'm not going to point you out, but I know there's some here that was alive here. And he said he could never figure out why they called it Happy Holidays. He said those people down there worked hard and they had no money. But he didn't understand why it was happening. But he said they were a close-knit family. And I want to tell you something. I had the pleasure with Willie and some folks the other day of looking at that monument. When you read that monument, people will know why this is called Happy Holidays. Because it was family. And if we had communities in our city that were still like that today, if we're family, we would have a lot less problems in our nation if communities had that family like Happy Hollows. So I want to thank Miss Kane, and I want to thank Lenore Kirkpatrick and Boo Rogers from our office. Boo is an eternal member of my staff. She's retired about 3 times, but she keeps coming back. And she knows about historical markers. And Sheila back there in the green took Boo's place. And Boo started this, and she handed off to Sheila, and it all worked perfectly. And I also want to thank the Eberhardt, because this is really on their property. But we looked a couple of weeks ago, Willie and Mr. Burke and several folks, and we thought this was the best place, because it's a central location, it's a nicely mowed area, people might want to stop it and read this place.
I was going to ask, I'd like to ask the pastor from Bethlehem, Mr. Hicks, to come, Pastor Hicks, and give us a blessing. And then Mr. Kane or Miss Kane, somebody. And I also want to make sure Bill Gillespie, one of our councilmen, is recognized. Because without the city council, we wouldn't have any funds to do things like this. So I appreciate the council and their hard work. We've got to remember historical parts of our community. You know, people, a lot of people, when they get to Prattmont, they think they're in downtown Prattville. They're not in downtown Prattville, they're in Prattmont. When they get to, people don't know what College Heights is or what some of our quarters are. We have to remember all of our history. It's vitally important because it's just near and dear to all our hearts. So, Pastor, give us a blessing, please.
Thank you. Let's bow. Eternal God, we come before you with the celebration, dear Lord, celebrating the preservation and also your faithfulness due to this community and to Happy Harlem. We thank you, dear Lord, for you have been faithful. You have preserved us through difficult times of drugs and times of violence, just times of growing pains in the community. But through it all, dear Lord, we still stand. We stand strong and we stand united and as one in your name. So we just want to say thank you. We ask right now, dear Lord, that you bless this family of families, this community, dear Lord, and bless this city. Bless the leader, the mayor, and all of those that came up with this idea, dear Lord, but have it spread and the idea spread throughout the community and bring the community closer together with the one with you being the center point and you being the focus. All that we do. We just want to say thank you. Thank you for the hearts and souls that are coming here for this occasion. Bless your blessings in their life. Watch over them, dear Lord, as they're going out and coming in, lying down and then rising back up. Bless them, dear Lord, from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Let's all say amen.
Amen.
Miss Kane, which one of y'all?
First of all, I think I spoke to everyone, but I'm so, it warms my heart to see you all here today. I haven't spoken to Councilman for that, so it's so good to see you. But I want to thank the mayor, and I have to say something about the mayor. There's people in my home room a few years back, and he told me when I asked about, you know, what people he wants to graduate from high school, he said, well, I want to be a politician. But when he became mayor of Prattville, I was not surprised at all. He has always been just a wonderful person. But I want to thank all of you for being here again. I want to kind of piggyback on what Councilman Wood said. This is a community project. We went around to groups. Roger has been tremendously. Sheila has been tremendous. And all of you that I interviewed have been tremendously. And I do appreciate that. We all know, those of us who grew up here in Happy Hollow, we all know that Happy Hollow was a wonderful community. And we have very, very fond memories of Happy Hollow. Especially, he's not here today, but especially my brother-in-law, Danny Kane, I mean, he can sit down and he can tell us some hilarious stories about his growing up in Happy Hollow. So I appreciate you all, and I cannot end this without thinking the Northeast Pastor, who's not here today, he's getting a lot of this, I think, to get this on the way, as well as Susan's parents here. So you see, it's kind of something everybody to make this possible in Happy Hollow. And my church family, I love you. Thank you so much for being here.
Good job. What we're going to do is we need to thank somebody very important, Miss Annette Ray in the chamber. She's got lemonade and goodies for us. So what we're going to do briefly is I'm going to ask Mr. and Ms. Kane and Councilman Wood and Bill, Councilman Gillespie and Mr. Burke to come over here. And we're going to unveil this and people can read it and get them some lemonade and visit, and maybe it'll rain and it'll run us all the way. Which way you want it, Sheila? This way?
Cool.
Hey, hey, hey.